structure and function. What is cell? Basic structural and functional unit of the life is called as a cell. It gives a perfect shape and size to the body. Based on number of cells, we have a two types of organisms that are nothing but unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. Unicellular organisms means it is having only one cell. For example, amoeba. Okay. Amoeba is one of the example for unicellular organism. It is having only one cell. In that one cell only total metabolic reactions are carried out. Next, multicellular organisms. Multicellular organisms is having different number of cell organelles for carrying out different metabolic activities. For example, human beings only. Next, microscope. Microscope is invented by Robert Hooke and Antoni van Leeuwenhoek. These two scientists invent the microscope. That having different types of microscope we are having. Simple microscope, compound microscope and electron microscope. By simpler microscope we can see that outer structure only. Next, compound microscope. By this compound microscope we can able to observe that outer the cell wall, cell membrane and nucleus we can observe by this compound microscope. By this electron microscope we can observe each and every part of the cell organisms we can observe by the electron microscope. Typical cell. What is typical cell? Which cell is having total number of cell organelles is called as a typical cell. For example, animal cell is having total number of cell organelles means that is a typical animal cell. If plant cell is having total number of cell organelles means typical plant cell. We have a typical animal cell structure here. Okay, this is the outer membrane and this one is the inner membrane and here total number of organelles will be there. One by one I will explain. Okay, this is the nucleus. This one nuclear membrane. Inside we have a genome, that is a DNA and RNA. This is the mitochondria. Here we have a endoplasmic reticulum. In that endoplasmic reticulum we have a two types, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Rough endoplasmic reticulum means which is having ribosomes, that is called as a rough endoplasmic reticulum, and smooth endoplasmic reticulum is not having ribosomes on the membrane. Okay, here some vacuoles will be there and Golgi complex and plastids will be there and this one is the total cytoplasm. This is called as a typical animal cell. We know that lysosome will be used for destructing the waste material. Next, ribosome. Ribosome will be involved in the photosynthetic process. We have a two types of ribosomes, that is 70S and 80S ribosome. 70S in a prokaryotes and 80S ribosomes will be there in the eukaryotes. Prokaryotes is nothing but some many unicellular organisms will be observed. And eukaryotes is an example of our human beings only. That is having 80S ribosomes. The ribosomes will be useful for the protein synthesis. Next, mitochondria. Major organ in our body is a mitochondria. Why we are calling it as a major organ? Because it is a powerhouse of the cell. It stores the ATP. It will be 2 to 8 microns in the length and 0.5 microns in the width. It is a smaller organ and it is able to observe under the electron microscope only. Next, we have a Golgi complex. That is Camillo Golgi is a scientist, invented the Golgi complex. That he observed the Golgi complex in a cell first time. Okay, this Golgi complex is a fluid sac like structure. It stores the material before transported to the other organs. Here we have a plastids. Plastids are having total three types of plastids. We know that keratins, xanthophylls and chlorophyll. That plastids are useful for doing the metabolic activities. We know that in the chlorophyll that photosynthetic process will be occurred. Here nucleus, we know that total information will be there in the nucleus only. The genomic character is having total our body information. Next, outer membrane and inner membrane will be protects the our animal cell.